San Diego braces for another round of dangerous fire weather as perhaps the strongest Santa Ana winds of the season descend on the county. I'm Catherine Garcia.
And I'm Mark Mullen. So let's get to your nightly check-in right now. The latest word from SDG&E is that more than 40,000 customers could have their power shut off this week to cut the risk of fires. The community span from Campo and Boulevard up through Alpine and Julian and even into portions of Rancho Bernardo, Escondido, and Encinitas. The complete list can be found on NBC7.com. Meanwhile, NBC7's Joe Little spent the day in Alpine talking to people getting ready for possible blackouts.
Electricity is still flowing through these power lines through Alpine and the Cleveland National Forest, but that could change in the next few hours. San Diego Gas and Electric expects the Santa Ana to start picking up this evening, but then really start blasting through San Diego County tomorrow morning.
Because of the possible power outages, classes will be canceled tomorrow in the Julian Union and Julian Union High School districts, along with the Mountain Empire and Spencer Valley School districts. SDG&E also plans to open 7 community resource centers where they will provide water snacks, phone charging stations, and water trucks for livestock. Those locations and times are also available on NBC7.com.
Meanwhile, a really close call in Ramona this afternoon. Fire crews were able to quickly jump on a small vegetation fire that burned dangerously close to several homes on Keys Road. In this case, fire crews say the wind actually helped them by pushing the flames away from houses. They held it to just 2 acres.
The winds will start to pick up late tonight with the strongest gust arriving tomorrow.
Here's Dagmar with your first alert forecast.
A high wind warning goes into effect at 11 p.m. Tuesday night. Expect the winds as we head towards sunrise and beyond in your Wednesday to gust into the 70 and 80 mile per hour range. Then you've got the red flag warning. That also goes into effect at 11 p.m. tonight, Tuesday. Extremely dry conditions, single digit relative humidity, and a whole slew of other issues as well. Air quality warnings, hard freeze warnings, freeze warnings. So very cold in the overnight hours. Your temperatures during the day won't be the issue. You're looking at the low 70s for the coast. Tomorrow, inland valleys, mid to upper 70s, mountains, low 60s, deserts, low 70s, upper 70s, dry, windy, red flag warning in effect.
San Diego police are searching for an armed robber who targeted 2 Subway restaurants.
NBC7 obtained the surveillance video of the robberies. The first was in North Park on September 15th. The second 3 days later, less than 5 miles away near Choyas Creek. Police say in both robberies, he had a black revolver.
Mumps cases have been reported at 3 separate high schools in San Diego County. Parents and staff were notified yesterday at High Tech High International, La Jolla High School, and San Pasqual High School. The county health department says there have been 47 mumps cases this year.
They're not calling this an outbreak, but they did tell us the people who are not vaccinated are clearly the most at risk. Mumps is spread through coughing, sneezing, or simply just being in close range with somebody who's infected.
Finally tonight, a plea for help from members of San Diego's junior theater production of School of Rock. Someone stole 4 guitars and a laptop from the stage and orchestra pit. It happened right after their first performance last Friday night at the Casa del Prado Theater in Balboa Park.
Like when I was sad, I would just go and play the bass, and having it stolen in a matter of maybe minutes and stuff, that's kind of heartbreaking, yeah.
The young actors were able to put on a show with the help of fellow musicians who let them borrow their instruments. Peter Bierbeck says they will be back this weekend for another round of performances to, quote, rock their worries away.
Good for them. The NBC7 app and NBC7.com will be your source for breaking fire coverage over the next few days.
You can also track developments on our social media accounts, and we'll break into programming on television for any major situations that develop. Have a great night.